Yeah, you know what? There's an awful lot of projection. I mean, it's probably not just in the social justice community. I think there's projection. Humans project often, especially if you've got psychological issues. You do a lot of projecting. If you're not comfortable with yourself, you often project. And honestly, I think the best way to predict what social justice warriors are going to do, if you want to predict what the left's going to do, just look at the stuff they're accusing everyone else of, because inevitably that's the stuff they end up getting caught doing all the time. I mean, you saw it with even with Trump's election. Oh, he's going to not accept the results of the election. Who didn't accept the results of the election? Right? Like, it's all the time. Oh, he's colluding with Russia. Actually, who was colluding with Russia? Like, it's one projection after another. And I think the racism thing on the left, my suspicion is that a lot of the white woke leftists are actually not just racist because they adopt SJW ideology, but racist in their hearts. They are racist, and they project out. It's like the guys, you know, the guys who get caught for sexual impropriety, not just impropriety, like rape or assault or some like horrible thing, right? They're always like, we men have to do better. And it's like, no, dude, you have to do better. Yeah. We men don't do that. You did that. Don't project your dysfunction onto the rest of us. It's the same thing. These leftist, these leftist, quote, I'm going to say, quote, anti-racist. They're really good marketing. They're not anti-racist. But these leftist, quote, anti-racists, they are projecting. They're like, oh, there's white supremacy is everywhere. There's institutionalized racism. They're keeping the black man down. I'm starting to wonder is that what you're doing? Like, are you actually really racist?
Yes.
Are you like, is this a confessional? Are you just telling us openly what's going on in your psychology? Because that's disgusting.
Yeah. No, they do. And I've seen it even over the past week on Twitter. There are guys doing it, exactly what you're saying. They're like, I admit, I saw this young kid. I can't remember who tagged me in this. There's been so much stuff the past few days. Tagged me in this white kid young man who was saying, you know, I have to admit, I'm here to confess on my personal page that when I'm driving and I pass a black person, I lock my doors. And I was like, dude, that's weird that you do that. Like, why are you saying? And he's like, basically, like, white people have to stop. Why are you speaking for me?
So I have a theory that did not come only for me. Mike Cernovich talked about this theory, but he was really talking about Republicans more. But I'm actually thinking this is I actually see this on the left. I think there's a submissive fetish going that's like tied in with all of this. I think there are people who this is why they're bowing and washing feet and like taking a knee. They've got some sort of innate self-hatred, maybe because they're really quite racist. Like, I don't know. Maybe they really look down upon black people for some reason. Maybe they're actually quite racist. A lot of these are rich liberals who don't hang out with blacks very much. And, you know, they're in the Presidio or wherever, right, in San Francisco.
That's also, by the way, that's why they believe all black people have the same opinion, because they don't actually know any black person who doesn't have that opinion, because they don't know very many black
people. Ta-Nehisi Coates says it, so it must be true. So, I actually wonder if they're really having this like deep-seated racism, and all of this stuff is just performative submissiveness. This is just them getting off on like, look, I can be humiliated publicly by kissing the ring of black power. It's disgusting, and it's your little fetish, and you should keep it to yourself. And if you want to go do that in your bedroom, I support your right to do whatever fetish you want to do in your bedroom, but don't write curriculum about it. Our kids don't need your fetish made into curriculums for the curriculum for them to go, you know, learn to be equally self-hating. It's pretty disgusting. It's pretty disgusting.
Yeah, Midwestern girl brings up, she says, remember that Facebook page Carrie's friend found that involved rather fetishy stuff? Yeah, for you guys who haven't seen our old episodes, there's a group on Facebook. I'm sure it's exploding with people now. It's called White Guilt Trading Post.
Oh, that one.
And it's a group where they've figured out how to monetize SJW ideology. A lot of people figured that out. But this in this group, anybody who's not white can post something and say like, hey, I need $30 because I want to go get my nails done. And then they'll be like, pay up, pay piggies. And then all these white people who consider themselves pay piggies, like come in and give them money and are like, you know, yes, I'm a paid pig. Like, it's really fetish. It's, there's something very sexualized about it. It's really creepy. Like you said, it's about being dominated.
Yeah.
And they talk, and they want to be talked down. They want to be talked down to.
Yeah. They want to be, there's no better word. They're subs. They're subs. They just want to be like they just want to be subby publicly. They want to be publicly submissive. You know, I don't know if it's natural or if they've been like beaten into submission somehow through friends and people around them, but it is kind of gross. It is kind of gross. I don't need to see it. You want to go wash someone's feet? Do it on Pornhub. Like, I don't need it on CNN. Right?
I don't need it on CNN. Go to your foot fetish community.
Yeah, go. That's fine. I support your right, but you know,
don't try and push it in schools.
Right. I don't know. Yeah.